Hello student, welcome back to the next session. In this session, let us start with a new chapter, that is data file handling. Data file handling. This chapter carries a total of 5 marks, in that you will be having 1 2 mark question and 1 3 mark question. Now, as an introduction, let us know what a file is. What is a file? File is a permanent storage, right? It is a permanent storage that is used to store your data and information which is required later. But a file is used in programming to store the results by the programs. Generally, a large amount of data will be stored in your files. The files will be stored in devices such as your hard disks, DVDs, tapes, etc., pen drives, etc., right? If you do not save the data, then later if you want the data for any other use, you will not be able to have it. So you have to store your files. Now, when you are saving, what are the things that you are supposed to do? What can you do? So in this chapter, the basic concepts of your files, that is how to open a file and the different modes, what are the different ways, that is different modes of file opening, the basic operations that you can do on files, all these things will be discussed in this chapter. Now, so as you know, a file may contain any type, not only text, it may contain image, it may contain text, it may contain voice, any different types of data. So you have to organize the data systematically for an efficient use or access. So the basic operations that you can do on your file, that includes creating a file. You have to create a file first, right? So you have to create a file. And then you will be writing the data into the file, and then whatever you have written, you will be reading the data. And if you want to make any changes to what you have done, that is you are appending the data, that is making changes to your data, appending the data and etc. So on. So in programming, we are not talking about the regular Word document or an Excel document or any such thing. We are talking about programming. So in programming, the file input and output statements are used. File input and output statements are used to access the contents of the file. So basically, definition for the file is, it is a basic storage unit that contains data or information. Now, there are different types of file input and output statements. That is your console input output statement, console input output statements, file input output statements, and port input output statements. The console input output statements, the first thing, you are already familiar with that because you are using your C++ programming, and in this C++ programming you have been using your iostream.h, right? In that you are using your C in, C out, the get line, put, etc., right? So these are all the statements that you are going to make use under your iostream.h. So this is a header file. A header file, iostream.h, contains the definitions of such input-output statements. So, using such input statements, console IO operators, a stream of bytes or characters can be sent from your input device to a program and using the output operators, it can be sent to your output devices. Right? Using a stream, you are going to send it to the input. From the input, it goes to the program. And using an output stream, you are sending it to the output devices. So now, what is this stream of bytes? We'll discuss that here. Now, file input and the output functions will be used for that purpose here. So the definitions of your, as we said, you are making use of the file input output statements, that whatever you are seeing here, right? So you are using that now. So let us know about your file input output statements. This is stored in the C++ library. You know what do you mean by a library statements? It is used in the C++ library, that is fstream.h. Therefore, inclusion of this, that is, I keep on telling you in the beginning of the programs, whenever you are writing hash include and all, right? Hash include, you have to include all the files that is necessary for your execution of the program. In the same way, if you are using your file IO statements, then you have to use hash include fstream.h, or it has got a substreams, that is under that, under fstream you have if stream or off stream. If stream or off stream can be used as per the requirements of your program. Now the next part, that is your header file, we were talking about that now also. So let us go a bit in detail about your header file. So the program files that you create, that is your .cpp files that we write whenever we store, save your files in C++, it automatically saves the, gives the extension as .cpp, right? These are created by the programmer. They are created by the user or the programmer, right? But there are some other files which is already present, that is predefined in the compiler to support the different functions and the operations. These files are known as your header files. So it is also known as your include files. You are going to include these header files. So header files can be identified by the extension .h. If there is a .h, that means that it is a header file. It contains the definitions of different functions and the operators that it supports. So depending on the requirement of the program, corresponding header file will be included. Now for example, iostream.h is used for your console input output functions, right? And you are using math.h for mathematical or trigonometrical functions. And ctype.h you are using for your character handling functions. And string.h is used for string manipulation, right? So on, you are using all these. Just see, all these are your header files .h extension. So in the same way, if you want to use your file input output statements, then you are going to make use of your fstream.h. So in C++, the file input output operations is similar to the console input output operation. They also make use of streams as an interface between the programs and the files. Now the stream class will link a file to the program for both the input and the output. Now the stream, now for example, the stream that is going to supply the data, the stream that supplies the data to the input, the stream, this part is important, remember, stream that supplies data to the program, this is known as your input stream. This is known as your input stream. Then it requires your if stream class, if stream class to represent the input, that is your file input. In the same way, the stream that gets the data, the stream that gets the data from the program, stream that gets the data from the program is known as your output stream. That is, it writes the received data to the file. It requires offstream class to represent your file output. Now, just if you are going to give a figure, now just imagine this is your input. It can either be a keyboard or from your file or anything. So this will be your input stream. And where are you going to give? You are typing it into your program. The data is going to your program. From this, where are you going to go? That is your output. This is your output. Where does it go? It can either go to your monitor or to a file, depending on which you are using. So this is the flow of your input and the output streams. Now, coming to your stream classes. This is an important 3-mark question. Remember, they may ask you to explain the different stream classes. C++ has the 3 classes to perform the input and the output characters to or from the files. That is off stream. That is, it helps, this stream helps to write data, to write data into a file. Okay, and if stream, this stream helps to read data from a file. It helps to read a data from the file. And then you have got F stream. That is, it helps to both read and write from, or you can read the data from a file or write the data to a file. So remember the 3 stream classes: off stream, if stream, and F stream. Off is only for your output, I input, F to both read and write, input and output. Then next you have, if you have your if stream and F stream, off stream, what is the default? Each of the open member functions has a default mode that will be used by default. What is it going to do? So that is, in your off stream, it will be in IO stream, that is input output stream, out mode. This is known as your mode. Out mode means it is used for writing purpose. If it is your if stream, it is iOS input mode, that is for writing, input purpose, reading. And then F stream, by default it will be in iOS out. That is, it can be used either for input purpose or output purpose. So these are the different modes that you have for your F stream classes. Now, shall we, let us end this session now. In the next session, I'll tell you, give you the hierarchy of the file stream classes, and we'll continue further.